Dear learners, let us continue our learning the core system software and compilers. This is the second video of the module 4. The topics covered under this session are lex and yak. In that one, regular expressions and examples of regular expressions. Myself, Dr. Suresh Adi from the Department of Computer Science and Engineering of Kendra Engineering College, Bantwal, Mangalore. In the last class, we have seen in a simple lex program, which will have the three different parts over there: definition section, role section, and the user subroutine section. Under the role section, we have the two parts. Again, it is a role section is divided into the two parts over there. The first part will be the pattern, and the second part will be the action. First will be the pattern, and the second one will be the action. So in the pattern, as we have told already, that is, here we are going to write the regular expressions. It will be written over there. Regular expressions will be written. So now, the regular expressions, even though we learned in the automata theory, let us recap again with other notations in the symbols used in the, in particular, the lex part of the regular expressions. The first part, the first character is the dot. So dot, it will matches any character. So it is used to match any character. The only restriction is except the new line character. So dot will match any character except the new line character. What is the new line character? The new line character is a backslash n. New line character is a backslash n. So it will match any character. It can be any key which is possible through our keyboard. All the keys can be matched with this dot. Suppose I want to recognize the entire line. So how to recognize? Just I can put it as a dot and the star. So star stands for zero or more occurrence. So star stands for zero or more. Zero or the more occurrence, we are going to use the star. So now what is the meaning of dot star? So dot means any character of any length. What is the ending point over here? So once we get our new line character, the new line character is our backslash n. Once we get our backslash n, we are going to break our reading. That is, a dot is used to match any character, whereas a star is used to match the zero or more occurrence of the previous one. If I write it as a star, so a star means what? Any number of a's. A star means any number of a's. That is zero or more number. Zero number is also included over there. For the zero case, you may remember we used to write epsilon over there. Epsilon stands for a string of length zero. The same thing is continued over here. The star stands for a zero or more occurrence over there. In the same way, we are going to use plus. So plus stands for one or more. Star stands for zero or more, wherein the plus stands for one or more. That is at least one. Here we have the at least case is there. If I write in place of A star, if I write it as A plus. The meaning is quite simple. What is that meaning? That is, at least I need to have one occurrence of the A. Plus stands for at least one. Star stands for zero or more. Dot stands for any character except the new line character. Any character except the new line character. Right? So in the same way, if I use pipeline. So this we already known. So this is for your OR operation. So OR means if I write it as A pipeline B. The meaning is quite simple. That is either A or the B. The meaning is quite simple. That is either A or the B. To match that one, we are going to use the pipeline. It is used over there. So next, if we continue. If we continue with it. So now I want to recognize a vowel. How we have recognized in the previous video, you may remember that I recognized using A, R, E, R, I, R, O, R, U. Fine. So this is used for recognizing the vowel. Fine. So now this is for your lowercase. So in the same way, if I add up with the uppercase letters, it will be uppercase A or uppercase E or uppercase I or uppercase O or uppercase U. So now if I go on elaborating this one, so this appears to be quite lengthy with the repetitive occurrence of this pipeline. So this pipeline is used for the OR operation, but the pipeline itself appears to be more over there. So now in these circumstances, there is one more option is there. So we can have the square bracket. Right? That is, it is used for the name of this one is a character class. We call it as a character class. The square bracket, we also call it as a character class. So now this, the advantage of using this square bracket. The advantage of using this square bracket is in place of this A, R, E, R, I, R, O, R, U. So now this I can write it inside the square bracket. That is A, E, I, O, U. Same way, capital A, capital E, capital I, capital O, and the capital E. And I will close this. So now this character class will match us any one character from this set. Not all. So this is used to match any one character from this set. Right? So now, if I want to recognize a character, simply an alphabet I want to recognize. So now what and all I need to write? I need to write it as instead of the year, I need to write A, B, C, D, E. I should continue writing this one till Z. Then again, uppercase A, uppercase B, uppercase C. Then I need to continue till the uppercase Z. So if I go for writing like this, again, this is a lengthy process, a long expression. Now to avoid this writing, there inside the character class, there is an option of using the hyphen. So hyphen means I want to recognize from A to Z, an alphabet I want to recognize. How to recognize? Small a to small z. Capital A to capital Z. That is, hyphen is used to give the range. So now what happens? Now this will match this A to Z. Hyphen stands for 2. That is, from lowercase a to the lowercase z and from uppercase a to the uppercase z. I can have any character. That is the advantage of using the square bracket along with the hyphen. Hyphen is used for the range. I want to recognize a number. How to recognize a number? Earlier I need to write it as 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So till I need to write it as 9. So now in place, I want to recognize a single digit. I want to write this one. Now in place of this one, how I can write it? I can simply write it as 0, hyphen, 9. Then I will close. So now this will recognize the number. That is the advantage having the hyphen in the square bracket. Now I want to recognize all the symbols other than the numbers. In those cases, a caret symbol is used. Fine. So how to use that one? Caret means it stands for negation 0 to 9. So this will recognize all the single characters except the digits. Except the digit 0 to 9, all the rest of the characters will be matched over there. If this square bracket, if this caret symbol, what do you, cap symbol, if that cap symbol is used inside the square bracket, it stands for what? A negation. This you have to remember. It stands for a negation when it is used inside the square bracket. Hyphen, when it is used inside the square bracket, it indicates your range. This indicates the range from 0 to 9. That is the meaning. This is used from inside the, used to give the range. So these are the various symbols what we can use inside the square bracket. First, the square bracket itself is used for the character class. Second one, if hyphen is used in the character class, in the square bracket, it is used to give the range. Then next aspect, if I use a caret symbol inside the square bracket, it is used for the negation. Meaning, leaving that one, rest you have to recognize. Leaving that one, rest you have to recognize. Fine. So now, I want to recognize the integer. How the integer will be if I take up the integer? Integer can be 12, 24, or 2, 4, 5, then 6, 7, 8. So now in this case, if I take up the integer over there, so now it is a number. So number means how I can use a, we can have the digits from 0 to 9. So now this will match one digit. But integer is not limited to a single digit. We can have any number of digits. But what is the minimum count? Minimum, I should have a one digit over there. To have that one, what is the symbol to be used for the at least one? What is the plus? Now to recognize the integer, we can use a 0 to 9. Plus can be used over there. This is how we can combine the things. So now we are discussing with the rest of the character. The caret symbol, in place of writing inside the square bracket, if I write it directly over here, without the square bracket, it indicates matches at the beginning of the line. It is used to match at the beginning of the line. Let me take one simple example. It is used to match at the beginning of the line. If I want to have a declarative statement, how the declaration will be there? Do you remember? First, I need to have a int, then followed by the variable list a comma b. This int is to be there at the beginning of the line. If I want to match this int at the beginning of the line, I should write it as a caret symbol and the int. That is, int will be recognized only if it occurs at the beginning of the line. To match at the beginning of the line, we use the caret symbol directly, that cap symbol. That cap symbol directly we are going to use if we want to match any token at the beginning of the line. So in those cases, we are going to use the caret symbol which is used over there without the square bracket. If it is applied within the square bracket, it has a different meaning. I told earlier, what is that meaning? It is used for the negation. Negation, leaving that rest you can take. It is used for the negation. If it is used directly, then it will match at the beginning of the line. In the same way, if you remember, the semicolon should be there at the end of the line. To match at the end of the line, we use the symbol dollar. Dollar is used to match at the end of the line. Caret symbol is used to match at the beginning of the line, whereas the dollar is used to match at the end of the line. How to write a semicolon dollar? The meaning is quite simple. The semicolon will be matched only if it occurs at the end of the line. The semicolon will be recognized only if it occurs at the end of the line. Right? That is, these are the two complements. To match at the beginning of the line, we should use caret symbol. And to match to the end of the line, we should use the semicolon symbol to be used over there. Right? Then along with this one, the other symbols if you take up. I want to match exactly if it comes once or thrice. I want to match A if it comes as one time, or it should come as a three time. Fine. So now in this case, we should put a restriction how many times it should come. So for those cases, we can write it as a flower bracket, then 1, 3. Fine. That is a 1, 3. Fine. So now this matches 1 to 3 occurrence of the letter A. This is used for the 1 to 3 characters occurrence of the A. That is 1 to 3 characters means what? We can have single A, 2 A's and 3 A's. How many times it can come? For that one, we can use that square bracket. That is how many times the previous expression is allowed. To match that one, we are going to use the flower bracket. That flower bracket, if I write it as A, B, I'll put it as a group, then this should come 3 to 5. So now this will be recognized. If I just write AB, this won't be recognized. If I write it as AB, AB, again, this won't be recognized. If I write it as AB, 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 now this is recognized. That is, AB will be recognized if it occurs 3 to 5 times. AB will be recognized if it appears 3 to 5 times. That is, from starting this to this one. Fine? That is, one here in this case, it is 1 to 3. In this case, it is 3 to 5. Fine? So, for that reason, how many times the previous pattern is allowed? For that one, we are going to use the flower bracket. That is, it is used to, in the first case, it is used to match 1 to 3 times occurrence of the letter A. In the second case, it is used to match AB together 3 to 5 times over there. Right? So now, let us take the example. I want to recognize in a floating point number. How it should be? It will be like this, right? 12.34. This is one floating point number. I want to recognize this one. So now in this case, what do we have? We need to have the 12. So to recognize it, that one, I can write it as a 0 to 9 plus. Then I want to use this dot. But a dot I can't use directly because it is a different meaning. What is that one? It can be any character. Dot stands for any character except the new line character. But I want to recognize the dot itself. In those cases, to recognize those meta characters directly, in those cases we'll prefix them with the backslash. Right? So this is the advantage of the backslash. That is, a backslash is used to suppress the additional meaning which is given to that character. That backslash is used to suppress the additional meaning which is given to the character. Suppose in the expression I want to recognize a star directly. But star is a meta character. What is the meaning? It stands for zero or more occurrence. But I want to recognize this star itself. I want to recognize this star itself. Now in this case, I want to use prefix this star with the backslash. I want to prefix this star with the backslash so that the additional meaning of the star is cancelled. Right? That is, to escape the meaning of the meta characters. Or to use those meta characters directly in your expression, we need to use the backslash before that meta character. Then to complete this one, this will be 0 to 9 star plus. Then again, it is a 0 to 9 plus. So now this will be the expression to recognize the floating point numbers, wherein we need to have both the parts. That is, the before the dot, I should have some digits. And after the dot, I need to have some digits over there. To recognize them, we are going to use the, this is the expression what we are writing. That is, backslash is a meta character which is used for to suppress the meaning of the meta characters. That's why we are going to use the backslash. The next one, question mark. Then the next one is the question mark. So now, if I take the example, plus 12 and just 12. So both are positive integers, right? Plus 12 and just the 12, both are positive integers. So now for the 12, I can write the expression. What is that expression? I can write a 0 to 9 star. But now, this part. So now plus may be there, may not be there. It is an optional one. That is, having the sign for the positive number is an optional part, which is allowed in the mathematics. Now, how to handle this case? For handling this case, we are going to use the question mark. That is, a plus is a meta character, but I want to use the plus directly. So, backslash plus and the question mark. So, now what happens? Plus may occur, may not occur. Means what? This question mark stands for zero or one occurrence. The question mark is used for the used to match the zero or one occurrence of the previous expression. We use the question mark. Right? Then next one. I want to recognize some of the keywords. Like I want to recognize a printer. I want to recognize this printer. So literally, I should get the same thing. That is, everything should match as it is. So in those cases, we are going to use the double quotes. So double quotes is used to match literally whatever it is present over there. That is, interprets everything within the quotes marks literally over there. Meta characters other than the C escape sequences will lose their meaning. They will have the same notation what we use. Means whatever we are writing in the double quote, that should match as it is. Then next one. A is to be recognized only if it is followed by the B. X is to be recognized only if it is followed by the Y. In those cases, we use the forward slash. Backward slash is to cancel the meaning of the meta character. We call it as an escape. It is an escape meta character. It is used to cancel the meaning of the meta character. Forward slash. Forward slash is used to match the preceding expression only if it is followed by the next expression. That is, I want to recognize A, B only if it is followed by the C. If I write A, B, C. So now in this case, this A, B is recognized as per this one. If it is followed by the D in place of C, if it is followed by the D. Now this is not recognized. Fine. That is to match that previous expression only if it is followed by the next expression. For those cases, we use the forward slash. For those cases, we use the forward slash. It is used over there. Fine. Then next one. To group. So here only I have done. To group some characters, we can use the common parenthesis. To group. Suppose I want to recognize a C-A-T, cat. So it is to be grouped over there. To group, for the sake of grouping, we use the common bracket, which is used over there. Common bracket is used. Right? These are the meta characters which are used in the regular expression. Now you can state the definition of the regular expression. Now what is a regular expression? Regular expression is a pattern description. Regular expression is a pattern description using these meta characters. Regular expression is the pattern description using these meta characters. Normally, this will be asked in all your Viva and the question papers. Define regular expression. So, what the regular expression is? A regular expression is a pattern description using the meta characters. Fine. So, what are the meta characters? We have listed a long list of meta characters. If we go for summarizing that one, first one is dot. It is used to match any character except the new line character. Then next we have seen the star, zero or more occurrence of the character, plus at least one or more occurrence of the character, question mark, zero or one occurrence of the character. Then the square bracket, it is used for the character class. Hyphen inside the square bracket, it is used to give the range. And the caret symbol inside the square bracket, it is used for the negation. Then next one is caret symbol direct. It is used for the to match at the beginning of the line. Dollar to match at the end of the line. Then next one, the backslash. It is an escape meta character. To cancel the meaning of the meta character, we are going to use the escape. Then next, pipeline. It is used for the OR operation. Normal OR operation, we use the pipeline. Double quotes. It is used to match literally whatever it is present inside the double quotes. Then next, the forward slash. It will match the previous expression only if it is followed by the following expression. Then next, for the grouping, we are going to use the common parenthesis, which is used over there. Okay. So these are the meta characters what we use in writing the regular expressions. Okay. So now let us try to write some examples for the regular expressions. Suppose I want to recognize a single digit. How I can write it? I can write it as a 0 or 1 or 2 or 3 or 4 or 5. That pipeline stands for the OR operation. Or 6 or 7 or 8 or 9. Fine. So this is one way. But the other way, we can use a square bracket. Square bracket 0 to 9. So now this is used to match the what a single digit over there. Now I want to have a number of digits. At least one. Suppose if I take up the integer, I need to have at least one digit. So what I need to write? I need to write the plus over there. Next, I want to handle the signed numbers. What are the sign options which are possible? Minus may be there or plus may be there. These two are meta character, any one. And they may be there, may not be there. Minus or the plus may be there, may not be there. How to do that one? This can be a question. Then 0 to 9 plus. This is how we go for adding up the contents over there. So now this is used to recognize the integer. Both the signed integer and the unsigned integers can be recognized using this one. Instead of this one, I want to use floating point number. That is a point, if I take the example 0.12, then 12.34. Both are valid. Means first, any number of digits, including zero number of digits. How to have that one? 0 to 9 star. Followed by a dot. Dot is a meta character. Use backslash. Then I should have the at least one digit. That is a 0 to 9 plus. 0 to 9 plus. Fine. So this will match these cases. Right? So this will match these cases. Now if I want to have a signed one. If I want to have a signed one, so what is the sign option? This part. What is this part? Square bracket. Inside that one, either I can have a minus sign or I can have a plus sign. And this whole thing is optional one. May be there, may not be there. So now this will, till here, this will be handling the unsigned one. Now this is handling the signed part over there. This is handling the signed part. If I want to have the scientific notation, how to handle that scientific notation? Again, to handle the scientific notation, what we need to have, that is E or the capital E. E or the capital E may be there. Then again, any one, square bracket. After that one, I can have the plus or the minus. That is either I can have the plus or the minus. Again, it is an optional sign. Followed by the digit. So digit may be 0 to 9. So this is for your scientific notation. This whole thing may be optional. Maybe there may not be there. If you put the whole thing in the question, whole thing with the